ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם שהכל נהיה בדברו. I am sure you know it by now. I was named ambassador of Venezuela in Israel, and because of this new mission, I have been to Israel on a couple of occasions for several weeks and lived there with the people, visited embassies, visited different offices of government, groups, went to different cities, went to the West Bank, Judea and Samaria. I did a lot of things in Israel. So what are my conclusions of these visits? What is new that I didn't know before? Actually, I had read about everything, but it's not the same being there, seeing things, than reading about it. I saw, for instance, so many new buildings coming up. Just a couple of days ago, a new fast train was inaugurated between Tel Aviv and Jerusalem, 25 minutes. You know, there are long columns of cars trying to get in from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem and vice versa. A trip takes an hour and a half, sometimes two, sometimes even more. And now 25 minutes by train, a rapid train that takes you from the two most important cities in Israel. You see tremendous progress in Israel. How did Israel come into being? In 1947, November 1947, the General Assembly of the United Nations decided we're going to create two states. There was a Palestine, so-called Palestine, as a mandate of the League of Nations that Britain was administering. We're going to divide it into two. A Jewish state and an Arab state. The Jewish state proclaimed its independence in May 14th, 1948, but the Arab state never came into existence. So that you only have a Jewish state, and then the other parts that is no man's land, but Israel claims historically that is really ours because it was divided in a manner that isn't legal. Well, these are arguments, but what is the reality? The reality is that you have a Jewish state and you do not have an Arab state there. However, Israel is surrounded by states that are not friendly to it. Even though today there are many more that are friendly to it, but there's one state in particular, Iran, that has said more than once that they want to erase Israel off the map. And Iran is not really an Arab state. They are different, but they're also Muslim. So this is what brings them closer to the Arab states. And we Jews are not Muslims, of course. So somehow Iran is now the greatest menace for the existence of the state of Israel. Now, I have lived in Venezuela, I lived in many countries, especially small countries. Take Cuba, for instance. Why don't they have more to give their people, to give to their people? Why in Venezuela are people going through hunger? You know what the answer is? The answer that governments usually tell you is, you know, we have enemies from without. We cannot grow because they don't permit us. And Israel is a response to all these false claims. You know, if there is any state that really should have a military government, it's the state of Israel. Because it has numerous wars with its neighbors. They want to destroy it. So it is certainly a territory that cries out for a military leader because the greatest danger of Israel is of a military nature, yet there was never a military dictator in Israel. There's no dictator. You know, I know two presidents of Israel that were jailed afterwards. The president has a lot of connections. You know, prime ministers lose their position. The present prime minister is being accused, indicted for whatever he did, whether it's right or wrong. These are not totalitarian states. To the contrary, it's a very democratic state, even though it has those around it that want to destroy it. So I want to tell all those small countries, their societies, that have an excuse, why don't you grow? Because we have enemies around us that don't permit us to do things. Israel demonstrates the contrary. To the contrary, maybe because of the danger, it is growing more. Israel spends a great sum of its gross national product in defense, because the most important thing is, of course, to survive. But yet you see enormous development in all aspects of life. Technology, you know, high tech is one of the most important products of Israel. It used to export, you know, oranges. Today it's something else. Today it exports brains. It exports new inventions, new findings, because maybe the fact that it's being threatened constantly makes them work harder than ever before. So don't use difficulties as an excuse of why you're not growing. I think that Israel is the best example that under very dire and difficult circumstances, you can advance. I was in the Judea and Samaria that is called the West Bank. I visited a factory that one man, he's a Jew from Tunis, but he's many years in Israel. I don't know if he went beyond high school, but he has over 100 patents to his name. The guy has built, I think, 3 factories in the West Bank. He knows every worker by name. And if anybody has a problem, they go to him. And there you have Israelis and Palestinians working hand in hand. Yet, I think it was a couple of years ago, somebody, a terrorist, came in for a couple of months, got a job there, and eventually killed 2 people that were working there. It left such a bad taste in the mouths of everybody. Here you have a factory that is actually giving work, giving future to people who live there. You know, the salary there is triple the salary that you get in any Palestinian factory, in these factories. As a matter, I spoke to a couple of fellows who were working there, but they seem to be a little bit specialized. I asked, what is your salary? I asked him. His answer was, it was a little over $2,000 a month. Well, it's not the greatest salary in the world, but you know what the salary in Venezuela is right now? $8 a month. Here he's getting $2,000 a month, and he's very happy. There was no police around there. I spoke to him, tell me, do you have any problems? Do you have difficulties because you're a Palestinian? Are you treated differently? Not at all, because the owner knows him by name. And when some child of this family fell ill, he got him special treatment because he identifies with each and every one of them. I think this is just a demonstration that when people know each other, when they work together, they can really live together. And what is most important is to remember that adversity is not a reason for lack of progress. To the contrary, Israel demonstrates that even under difficult situations, you can certainly grow.